Welcome to your February 2nd to 7th, 2019 love reading. This is the general reading for Sagittarius. Now, sometimes finances can come into this as well, so keep that in mind. The cards are already starting to drop out for you, and with every reading, I always burn the sage, and I always have my beautiful healing stones that help clear any negative energy out of your reading, okay? So for those of you that are brand new to my channel, welcome to shasietarot. Appreciate you being here. Now, never force a reading to fit your situation. Remember, this is a general reading. So some things will resonate, some things will not. Never force a reading to fit your situation, okay? Remember, we all have our free will to make our own choices. This is meant as guidance only, okay? And for those of you returning, thank you so much. And thank you for subscribing and sharing and liking my videos. I really appreciate it. I really, really do. I've definitely been divinely guided here to do this for you. I've been doing tarot since I was 13 years old for myself, but I've really dug my heels in and was divinely guided here when something happened in my life, if you read my intro video, that led me to doing this for you all the time. And I can't put the tarot cards down. I do a reading for myself every morning and every night. And anyhow, so with that being said, we're going to go ahead and get started. Now, energies, this is a timeless video, okay? Whenever you're feeling this is your life story I'm talking about, then it's meant for you. Things can happen weeks later, tomorrow, yesterday, 6 months from now, okay? So anyhow, let's go ahead and get started. If you're feeling that I'm talking about you and this fits your situation, okay, then it's definitely meant for you. No matter when you're watching this video, you'll definitely want to probably take advantage of the extended read, which will be available below after this video. It's really inexpensive and it's really worth it because it's another 15 plus or minus video that goes into great detail. I pull a lot of cards from other decks for clarification. Let's go ahead and get started. So Sagittarius, this is your energy. This is wands. This is fire. And we know you're full of fire. And that's a good thing. Okay, so that's Leo, Sagittarius, or Aries. So the five of wands specifically speaks about somebody going through a lot of challenging times right now. You know, a lot of obstacles can be with family or friends, anybody that sort of gives you a headache or stresses you out, you know, and it can be people in your ears, right, giving you their opinions, whether you want them or not. It can be sometimes, you know, rivalry, challenges, anything that's an obstacle, okay, that's giving you grief. Then you have the Two of Swords. So you could be at a crossroads, a point of indecision about something in your life. Maybe you're feeling blindfolded as to which way to go. You're indecisive, you're confused. That could be trying to make a decision about something or someone. You have the Three of Pentacles. So this is earth energy, Taurus, Capricorn, or Virgo. You may be wanting to collaborate or have teamwork with somebody. It could be in a relationship. Maybe you're wanting to work together. Maybe you're wanting to work together on a decision about something or someone. That could be, and it can be business. But seeing as how we've got this fantastic and beautiful Ten of Cups here, it could be regarding a relationship. This is the whole shebang, the whole enchilada. This is the Ten of Cups. See that beautiful rainbow? This is happy family, happy life, love, abundance, joy, health, wealth, everything that we always want right here. Okay, we're going to do some clarifying cards to figure out what's going on here, because we've gone from conflict to indecision, being possibly confused or making a choice between a person, a work, whatever it is. You're trying to make a decision and wanting teamwork. It can be regarding relationship. Maybe there's been some challenges that are trying to prevent you, interference from having this Ten of Cups, something that you really want with somebody else. But let's go ahead and clarify that Five of Wands. Clarify the Five of Wands, please, for Sagittarius, please, Spirit. Why is the Five of Wands here? Clarify the Five of Wands. Clarify the Five of Wands, please, for Sagittarius. Why is the Five of Wands here, please, Spirit? Ooh, too many cards. Let's do that again. clarify the Five of Wands, please, for Sagittarius. Leave me any comments down below. I love to hear from you. I read every comment that everybody writes, and in the evenings, once my girls are asleep, I go on and I definitely try to answer almost every comment, okay? You have the Three of Wands. So, overcoming obstacles and frustration, strong opinions of other people, maybe possibly regarding a relationship or something to do with teamwork of some sort, can even be in a business. But with the Ten of Cups here, I tend to think this is about a relationship. It can be mother-in-law, father-in-law, brother, sister, friend, whatever the case may be. There's been conflict here. So somebody here is trying to, you know, make choices and decisions, looking forward, waiting for those ships to come in, waiting for something to happen that's positive, ready to move forward, I'm feeling here. This is wanting, again, teamwork, possibly thinking about traveling and expansion. Again, making a decision about something or someone. You may be trying to make a decision about moving forward with what you know could be your Ten of Cups, your complete total abundance and happiness. You may be thinking it's about somebody at a distance from you where you could have this with, or vice versa. Remember, this can be reverse, okay? It can be your love interest that you're thinking about, okay? That may be the challenge. Maybe you're at a distance from each other and, you know, people and friends or family members are in your ear and you're trying to make a decision, okay? That could be. Again, turn this around if this is your love interest, okay? Let's clarify that Two of Swords, please, for Sagittarius. Why is the Two of Swords here, please? That was quick. Four of Cups. Maybe you're refusing love at the moment, okay? Maybe something has been difficult for you, or this could be your love interest. Cups is emotions. That's Cancer, Pisces, or Scorpio. You could be involved with one of those signs, or else it simply just means that the universe is trying to bring in this beautiful Ten of Cups energy to you, this beautiful abundance to you, or vice versa, to your love interest. But somebody's not ready to accept it because they're going through a lot of conflict and indecision right now. And it can be over something that they've lost. Could be a previous love relationship here that they've let go of, or somebody's let go of them and they're focusing on that. They're focusing on what was rather than what could be here. You see? Okay. So whether that is you or your love interest, we don't know. I don't know. You know how this resonates for you. Let's keep going. Let's clarify the Four of Cups, please, for Sagittarius. There's a lot of people going through a lot of transitions right now in their life. It's just remarkable. Clarify that Four of Cups, please, Spirit. Why is that Four of Cups here for Sagittarius? Clarify the Four of Cups for Sagittarius, please, Spirit. Woo, flying out. Yeah, most definitely. Somebody is definitely focused on a loss rather than what is here or what could be. So whether that's you or your love interest, and again, it could be a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, could be a Taurus, Capricorn, or Virgo, a Libra, an Aquarius, or a Gemini, or a Sagittarius like yourself, Leo, or an Aries. We have almost every sign here already. But somebody's focusing on what was lost, not what could be here. So whether that's you or your love interest, you would know. Oh, that happens a lot. I mean, look at this beautiful Ten of Cups waiting here. But there is an ending here. Somebody went through a very difficult, painful ending. Somebody may have been betrayed. Something was painful. And somebody is definitely feeling that loss. But the good news is, yes, there is good news. This is the ending of a cycle. Tens are the end of a cycle and difficult time. So what goes down and is the end of will come back up. There is a new beginning here. And I believe that's what Spirit's trying to say with this Ten of Cups. Once somebody gets past this indecision, okay, there's something beautiful waiting. This is what we all want. Right here, this is what we all want. Complete happiness and bliss here. So once somebody lets this painful energy go here, this new beautiful rainbow of abundance, love, happiness, health, wealth, everything will come in. But somebody has to heal first after something very difficult ended. That's how I'm feeling. There was definitely an ending to a situation. And someone's wanting an equal give and take here. But somebody needs to make a choice first before there can be an equal give and take, possibly it looks like in a new relationship. But there's been challenges. Somebody may be at a distance from you, you from them, and somebody's trying to make decisions and changes, but having a lot of challenges along the way. Okay? And it can be, again, with family members or a former, you know, a former love interest that where it has ended. Maybe somebody was betrayed. That could be. However the relationship ended, either yours or someone else's, some your love interest's previous relationship, that could be. Let's clarify the Ten of Swords for Sagittarius, please. Why is the Ten of Swords here for Sagittarius? Again, in the extended read, we're going to dig a lot deeper. Now, I do have my enchanted tarot that I've had for a great number of years here. They really jump out for me. You can see how old they are. I've had them ever since I was 13 years old. I'm not going to date myself here. But these are a lot. I mean, about 25 years. Okay. And they really jump out. So we're going to definitely pull some of them. And I got some beautiful new cards in. They're angel messages and they're fantastic. Okay, so I will definitely dig into those for you, as well as, of course, the Angel Romance cards by Doreen Virtue. So we're going to pull a lot more cards for you. I'm going to pull more besides that. I have about four different decks here for you. So, okay, you have the Nine of Wands. So somebody's very guarded right now, and I'm feeling it's quite possibly your love interest here. They have ended something, or if they haven't yet, they're contemplating it or they're going to. It was very painful. They may not have wanted to end what is ending or about to end, or this could be you. But someone's very guarded, and it could be you that's guarded. It could be you. Okay. Somebody is guarding their heart, and they're not willing to put in the work yet into a new relationship to have this beautiful abundance that's waiting for them. They could be healing right now, okay? Again, we're going to pull a lot more cards. But that's how I'm feeling. They've been wounded. They've been through a lot. They've been through a lot of conflict, a lot of fighting. And they just sort of are protecting themselves right now. That's how I'm feeling. We're going to go ahead into the extended now. We're going to pull a lot more cards. Definitely check it out. If this is resonating for you, please hit that thumbs up and subscribe. I really appreciate it. If you want to donate to the channel, that is also down below. I will go ahead and pin the extended link down below in the comment section as well. And please tell me your stories. I love to hear from you. Write anything you like down below. Just keep it clean and happy. We want to hear happy, positive thoughts, and I love it when you all talk to each other too. That's awesome to see. So with that being said, thank you again so much for all of your support, those that are you returning to me. It's fantastic. And yearly forecasts, Sagittarius, I don't believe I've gotten to yet. I apologize. I just haven't had time. I've been doing the weeklies and the dailies. So thank you so much for being here. And those of you this resonated for, I will see you at the extended. Those of you that are leaving me now, thank you so much. I really appreciate all of you. Have a fantastic rest of your day. And bye for now. Bye-bye.